Hey guys, it's Flaming Sheep here with another Gatecrash release draft this time. Cards in this pack I'm looking at are Rubble Belt Raiders. Looks pretty sweet. I think I'll probably take it. Other cards that are noteworthy, the Knight of Obligation, Sun Home Guildmage. Now this card's a bomb all in itself. So the pick might actually be, now I'm wondering, the pick might actually be the Sun Home Guildmage. This card can win on its own. But so can that. I mean, there's an Assault Griffin. Totally lost. I think it's definitely between the Rubble Belt and the Sun Home. I'm going to take the Rebel Belt and see what happens. And I actually get a pit fight, which is not horrible. It's actually quite good. Braintree Emissary is pretty sweet, too. There's a Simic Flux Mage, which is ite. It's ite. Keymaster Krasis, some good Simic, but we're going to go with that card. And then what do we get now? A whole lot of nothing. Aetherize. Wow. Okay, I mean, I guess these are all green, so this could technically be Simic still. So sure, I guess I'll take the Aetherize. It's a strong card. It's kind of defensive, but strong. And then there's Greenside Watcher I'm not going to take. This guy's good. This is pretty sweet, but we'll take the Aetherize, I guess. Passing the Sun Home, ugh, I don't know how I feel about that. Especially now that I'm seeing... Well, there's a Frill to Oculus. I mean, again, if I'm going Simic or during Skyjack, if I want to go Boros. I mean, passing the Sun Home, but then taking this sends a weird mixed signal. I mean, it's pretty aggressive. Maybe more so than this card. But I did take the Aetherize, so this would play more with Aetherize, although Aetherize is defensive. One of these two. I'll take the Frill Oculus for now and see if we can make the Simic thing work. Should I have taken the Sun Home? Maybe I should have taken the Sun Home. It's probably better than this. It's hard to say, I don't know. We'll find out. We will find out short enough, my friends. Short enough. Soon enough. Yeah, lots of good white here. Defensive, though. All defensive cards. There's a Gruul Ki Rune. This card's garbage, and this card's not bad. Yeah, I think this card's fine. There's a Spell Rupture as well, and a Simic Guildgate. I'll take the Miming Slime. I think it's going to be decent. It's probably going to be, what's power? Probably going to be like a 3-3 or higher, hopefully. Pretty sweet. Let's get our Evolve on now. Let's get some cards that are good Evolve creatures. There's some Guildgates. There's a Shamble Shark. Demer Charm. All interesting cards. Syndicate Enforcer. Syndicate Enforcer is always an interesting one. I'm going to go with the Shamble Shark. It's a pretty sweet card. So I think we're in Simic. I think that was actually the right pick to not go into, not consider this one the red card. Because I'm not seeing too many amazing red cards. There's Ooze Flux as well, which is actually decent in a, one of these type of decks. Although I don't have anything much with tokens right now. I feel like in a dedicated Simic deck, this card's pretty good. There's also Agoraphobia, which is decent removal. Sort of a very defensive card, though, because, again, it doesn't remove blockers, right? So maybe I'll try this. Again, it's sort of early in the format. I'm willing to try interesting, different things. And that's interesting and different enough. There's also a Demer Guildgate or a Prophetic Prism. I'll take the Guildgate in case I need to splash something. So there's a massive raid came back, but there's totally loss, which is totally fine. And I think he'll take it. So that's our pack, right? So I've got a couple things that make plus one counters right now. Hopefully we'll get more. And hopefully by, actually, this is not bad. By passing the Sun Home Enforcer, or Sun Home Guildmage, it's telling the guy to my left, like, go, like, definitely go into the colors I am not, which are red and white. So it's not bad. Ride Gear, I guess, would be the most playable of these cards. Shao Slice, meh. Psychic Strike, meh. Sky Games, meh. I'll take the Shao Slice. I think it's probably the best card here. A late Spell Rupture I'll take. Won't complain about that. So hopefully this sets me up for a really good pack too. I feel like I've cut the green and the blue as heavily as one can. We'll see. Triple green makes this a little bit prohibitive, but maybe if I get a Simic Guildgate, it'll make things much better. So, thoughts. Thoughts on this set so far. Think it's High Priest of Penance? Yikes. And here's a Zamek Guildmage. Pretty sweet. This card's also pretty sweet. And this card, and this card, and this card. But we're going to go with the Guildmage. That's probably a no-brainer, right? Yeah. So I think a good card would be like the Ivy Lane Denizen or whatever it's called. The one that gives plus one counters when you play green, guys. I think that'll be good combo with this. Other cards, the card that makes guys trample when they have plus one counters, or fly if they have plus one counters, those cards would be nice. Here's another thing, and again, with the Ooze Flux, yeah, this is, I probably have a lot of ways to play with plus one counters right now, which is fun. What the heck's this do? 7 for 5/5 flying. Oh, Gift of Azorva, that card's sweet. And then a Slaughterhorn would be the only other thing I'd give up. I mean, like, I would probably 100% take the Slaughterhorn. Except, I'm curious about this. 7 for 5/5 flyer is kind of interesting. And you can get a free instant or sorcery spell. It's not the best one. But it's a 5/5 flyer. 7 is a little hard to get to. Slaughterhorn is a better card. Probably, but again, want to play with the interesting cards since it's early on. There's a Mind Eye Drake, a Frilled Oculus, Death Cult, Gruul Charm, Bad Against Us, maybe. There's a Keymaster. Any comes into play abilities I care about? I think the Frilled Oculus is probably the pick here. 2-drop, efficient. Yeah. 3 toughness pumps up a lot of evolved stuff. Then we have a Disciple or a Shamble Shark, and we're going Shamble Shark here. Wrecking Ogre, what's that card do? Ooh, this card's a beast. That card is a beast. Yikes, someone's getting paid with Wrecking Ogre here. We're going to take the Shamble Shark and really hope that we don't get destroyed by that. That looks terrible. Ugh. Well, we have our Slaughterhorn here, and I'm happy to take it now. So we have a Simic Guildgate, Greenside Watcher. I think we take the Guildgate here. Yeah. I mean, it's between the Greenside Watcher and the Simic Guild Gates. Think I kind of just want the fixing now. Just because of the triple green here. Makes that a lot better. Plus makes splashing other colors a lot better. There's our Ivy Lane Denizen we were talking about. Hydroform, Clingonemones. But we'll take the Denizen. Skarg Goliath. I guess we're going fat all the way, right? This card's sweet. This card will win you a game. Alright, 7 drop. Ho! We have another Frilled Ocklus or another Adaptive Snapdraw. Let's go Frilled Ocklus again, I think. Sage's Denizen. Yeah, Sage's Road Denizen's fine. It's a fine card. Holy cow, that's a late Skarg Goliath. 7 mana, ho. This is pack 2. We've got a deck already. So I wouldn't mind a key rune or two just to get up to this garbage here, this 7 mana garbage. Yeah. Miming Slime. So, do I take the Mind Eye Drake, very defensive card, or the Gruul Charm, which, how many flyers do I actually have? Not a lot right now, to be honest. So maybe it doesn't hurt me that much. Take the Anemones. Mean, this is looking like a deck already. What I would love is some more like some Cloudfin Raptors or something to get like more of an aggressive start here. Like Mind Eye Drake, not exactly what I want in an aggressive deck. 5 for 2/5 flyer. This is really the epitome of defense. Molten Primordial. Orzhov Charm. Guardian of the Gateless. Man, so many good cards that I can't use. Zyrtas Swine as well. I guess we just take the Scab Clan Charger. It's so unimpressive. Madcap skills. This guy, this guy, this guy, this guy, this guy, all good. This guy. All good cards that I can't play, unfortunately. Signal the Clans. 1000 Lashes, also good. There's Snapjaw, and there's Disciple of the Old Ways. I think I'm good on my two drops. I think we're going to adapt to Snapjaw here. Splash removal. Wow, there's really nothing here for me. Getting cut pretty hard on Simic. Probably I could splash removal. I think that's not a horrible idea. Or I could splash for Ruination Worm. The card's pretty sweet. I'll take the removal, I guess. Elusive Crassus is probably the pick here. Over. Almost nothing. I mean, this card's sweet, but not gonna splash for it. This, if I want to splash black. More ley line, maybe, but we're gonna take the Elusive Crassus. I think that'll get through. Plus that is gonna be sweet, right? Unblockable, and then boom! 9 damage. Probably not going to play Force Adaptation or Riot Gear or maybe even Devouring Flesh. Mind Grind. So here's a Simic Key Rune. I was talking about that. I think I do want it. And there's nothing else here better. There's a Demer Guild Key Rune. Again, might be worth it just to get up to these 6, 7, 8 drops. that I've got going on here. I think totally acceptable choice over a clinging anemones, number two. I think that's totally fair. Plus, that kind of means that I can really splash this devour flesh. Not that it's the most exciting splash, but it's doable. This was directed removal, it'd be way better. As it stands, it's only okay. Whispering Madness. Interesting. Guess I take the naturalize here, right? Naturalize or cut a card. Take the naturalize to the sideboard. Merfolk of the Depths. This card looks not great, right? Pseudo removal? Or do I just run Dimer Gilgate number two? For what end, though? To splash a Devour Flesh? It's really not that exciting. Merfolk of the Depths. 4-2 Flash. I want to like this card. I'm going to take it. I don't even know if I'm going to play it. But I want to like it. I mean, I feel like it's got some evolve trickery and some awesomeness that I think it can ambush something and kill it. It's like pseudo removal. It is also six mana, which blows chunks. That part not so exciting. I don't think I'm going to play Devour Flesh. That just seems not great. In which case, I probably won't play the Dimer Kirin either. Probably no Devouring Flesh, probably no Dimer Kirin. Takes us to 25 cards. Anything here? Wow, this card should not be here so late. We're gonna take that, I think. Man, that card's awesome. What the heck? Don't think I want the Mind Eye Drake. That takes us to 24. Cut one more card. Spell Rupture. Sage's Row. Clinging Anemones? I mean, I guess it combos with this and combos with that other stupid card that I want to play with that moves around counters. Ooze Flux. So Spell Rupture is probably the card that gets cut. So that's a 23 card deck. No need for the Dimer Guildgate. 23 card deck with a 6, 7, and 8 drop, and 2 5s and a lot of 4s. Probably need to cut one more card. Maybe Sage's Row Denizen needs to go. Hard to say. Skyrark for the sideboard? Sure. I wonder if this is good enough. probably not in the main board, actually, now that I think about it. Have one naturalized ray. I don't think I need a second one. Take the last thoughts. Still want to play it, though. Maybe the Diluvian Primordial is not great enough. 7 for 5-5. Five, five. Eh. Not amazing. If it was 6 mana, that'd be pretty sweet. And 7 mana, not great. I think it's the anemones, but I guess, again, it works with... Like, I could pump this guy up for a bit and then ooze flux out some stuff or draw cards off it. So it does combo with things. I think this is the deck here, to be honest. I mean, Miming Slime plus Adaptive Snapjaw is pretty sweet. Or Merfolk of the Depths, Skarg, obviously. Some key rune. So what did I put in that I probably didn't need to? Oh, it was the spell rupture. I think this is fine for a deck. Let's see what they suggest here. Don't need any of those. So I could go 9-8. Is that a good spread here? Yeah. It's totally fine. Miming Slime's kind of like a not a creature. Pit Fight, Ooze, Aetherize. Yeah. Alright, let's see what happens. Thanks for watching and see you on the other side.